with our second section that is dedicated to the pilot testing in Emilia-Romagna. And the first contribution is the one of Daniele Mezzogori and Gloria Cheppini from Confagricoltura. They will launch a PowerPoint that is also a video message. So good luck, Daniele, with your presentation.
Thank you, Daniela. Hello to everybody. I share my video.
You have to share also the audio, okay?
Yes, I do.
Nice.
You can see my...
Yes, yes. Yes. Okay.
Good morning, I'm Daniele Mezzogori, and she is my colleague Gloria Cheppini. We work for Confagricoltura, an organization that represents farmers in Italy and in the Europe. The test phase carried out by Confagricoltura in the Rail Waste project was realized in collaboration with Chile RPA, a selective research center with headquarters in Emilia-Romagna, specialized in livestock productions. The results that we present today refer to the reduction of non-organic waste in general, and in particular, to the reduction of road-based nets and fumes for sewage that became waste. The trial focused on Emilia-Romagna Chile Lazio farm.
We will start by saying that agriculture sector impact on the total production of national waste for about 0.2%. There are no specific national data on waste produced by the dairy sector. The research carried out in the dairy livestock companies shows that the main non-organic waste produced are those shown in table one. For example, packaging for detergents, disinfectant, exhaust oil, iron, plastic material, plastic irrigation pipes, waste electrical and electronic equipment. The figure one shows that 49% of inorganic waste produced are linked to the Roundel net as sewage fumes became waste.
The trial was divided into two phases. In the first phase, 15 agricultural companies were involved, 11 producing Parmigiano Reggiano, 3 Grana Padano, 1 Squacquerone cheese. The second phase was done on 5 companies chosen to guarantee different dimension and with a protection for innovation. As you can see, the profile of the 5 companies was composed in small, medium, and large companies that produce 1 company Grana Padano, 3 companies Parmigiano Reggiano, and 1 company Squacquerone cheese. The table shows also the period in which the trial was held in 2019. In all companies, is relevant the production of round bale nets waste. Moreover, in farming in which the PDO, product denomination of origin fields, allows the use of sewage, is the relevance also the production of a plastic sewage fields.
The purpose of the research was twice. With phase one, we have analyzed the strategies to reduce inorganic waste in the livestock dairy sector of Emilia-Romagna, collecting information on the current process in use, verify types and quantities of waste, and the problem of company to reduce waste. The goal was to provide 15 light assessments and general recommendation for reducing inorganic waste. The purpose of phase two instead was to identify the possible innovative solution available for the prevention of inorganic waste for environmental and economic sustainability. The goal was to provide a 5 business plan in each 40
Each company.
Each company.
In the first phase were produced 15 light assessments. The information was collected by direct meeting survey on business characteristics, main production, milk, forage, specialized crops, method of forage harvesting and storage, production of inorganic waste, referring to 2018, etc.
The outcomes of phase one are 15 light assessments and some general recommendations to reduce non-organic waste from dairy companies. The main recommendations identified are to protect roundel nets and plastic silage film became waste, to avoid wind, rain, and further contamination of soil and water in order to keep the material dry and clean. To use large container for detergents with the possibility of refill the containers. To adopt LED lighting system in order to reduce the electrical consumption, the maintenance, and the production of hazardous waste. To use plant protection products contained in biodegradable packaging. To use plastic sealed film with reduced thickness, maintaining the same resistance index.
In the second phase, 5 studies were carried out with the aim of identifying mature technologies or innovative processes with the aim of reducing or eliminating non-organic waste. Realize economic analysis based on a change in the production parameters and costs, make a calculation of the carbon footprint, identify KPI, key performance indicator.
The outcomes of phase two show the type and quantity of waste producing dairy sector, see figure one, and the results of KPI. That highlighting, looking at the economic indicators, that the waste management doesn't have a big relevance. In fact, we have just an impact on turnover about 0.08%. Highlighting also that plastic round nets and sealed film has the main waste impacting on companies' production. 0.9 is the higher value of the technical indicator. For this reason, the test focuses on two pilots. Pilot one, so reducing plastic round bell nets, and pilot two, for reducing plastic sealant film.
Regarding the outcomes of the 5-business plan, focus on nets for round bales and plastic films, this study highlighted that the economic and environmental benefits of each alternative solution to the use of traditional plastic materials can be considered universally valid for all farms in the livestock sector. Therefore, the choice of an alternative solution to the traditional one will be evaluated on the basis of the company characteristics, size, management, production cycle. At the moment, there are no available solutions for the use of biodegradable plastics to replace nets for round baits and the plastic fields. So the main solution investigated in the pilots the reduction of round bale nets in high density polyethylene. The alternative solution are use of a round bale net with a 5% lower weight, polypropylene twine, sisal twine, use of the big baler, use of the two-stage high-making process of loose high. For the pilot two, concerning the reduction of the plastic sealage film, the alternative solution are use sealage film of less thickness, use of high-lage round base.
Always regarding the outcomes of phase two, taking into consideration the dry matter intended as the forage material, It was analyzed for each alternative of each pilot, the cost, first column, the quantity of CO2 equivalent produced which expressed the environmental impact, working hours, and the quantity of waste produced. And the table shows, for example, that solution 5 for pilot 1 with a value of 21.6 is the more expensive compared to the 5 alternatives analyzed. Solution 2 of pilot 2 with a value of 39.3 is the more expensive than the other one. On the other hand, with respect to the environmental impact, the first solution of pilot 1 is among the best, even if there is a moderate production of inorganic waste with a value of 0.5. The value has been estimated taking into account the real farm's characteristics. For this reason, they cannot be considered or universally valid in all situations. In different contexts, the numerous variables that influence these processes may show different data. Also, based on the results on phase 2, as described in the previous slide, the environmental and social analysis conducted on the alternative of each pilot test assigned a score in the area of sustainability, cost reduction, a degree of replicability. As shown in the table, solution 1 of pilot 1, minus 5% thickness, and 2, propylene twine, are the best performing solutions with a score of 19 and 20. With reference among the two best performing solutions is the one related to the use of the net with a reduced thickness of 5% because it's more sustainable and for the purpose of reducing plastic. With reference to pilot 2, the highest score was obtained by solution 1, minus 50% film thickness, with a score of 18.
In conclusion, the trial phase of the rain waste project has shown a substantial difficulty in significantly reducing the use of plastics, at least with the technologies currently available. Alternative materials with the same performance are not available at the moment. Therefore, it is necessary to focus not only on the search alternative and applicable solution in different agricultural sectors, but also to work to promote good practices and technologies that can increase the degree of recovery of these plastics by cleaning up these waste from land, water, and plant residues that often affect its recyclability. Finally, we want to emphasize, although not tested, that it may be useful in agriculture to encourage the replacement of goods and cover containing asbestos. In all the cases investigated, asbestos was found in a compact form. In the table, the summary of measures to improve management of inorganic waste in the agricultural sector is shown. Thank you very much for the attention and see you soon.